Today we're going to cover some of the new additions to Dynamo for Revit 2022.1. Specifically, we're going to look at some of the new Revit nodes available to us, and we'll touch on a few of the new UI changes as well. So let's get right into it. So with Dynamo in Revit 2022.1, we now have this Dynamo menu. Under this Dynamo menu, we can see our About page that we're pretty used to and we've seen before. We do see that we are on version 2.12 now. That's the important thing. This has been out in Dynamo Sandbox for a little while for testing, but it is now in Revit. What's exciting about this is the addition of quite a few new nodes that we'll look at here in this video. I do have the release notes open for this Dynamo release that are on the Dynamo GitHub page. I'll link to that below, but we'll walk through a few of the nodes that I think are really exciting. So if we were to go to Revit Elements Ceiling, we'll see a few new nodes here. As you may or may not know, the Revit 22 API added ceiling creation to it, which we've never been able to do before. So they added that ability to the Revit API for us to use. So naturally, package authors added that ability to their packages, and we've been able to do it in Revit 22 since it came out. But with this Dynamo release, it represents these nodes being out of the box. This makes me pretty excited as a package developer because I created ceiling nodes. Me removing those from my package is probably something that's going to happen fairly soon. But when there's an out-of-the-box node, I tend to recommend that over a package, even though I am an advocate for packages to be used. If you have an out-of-the-box alternative that works just as well for your needs, you should always use it. So what we could do is we can navigate to ceiling. We'll place the first one. There are two nodes in here. The first one takes a list of curves. The second one takes a poly curve, which is really cool. In my case, I want the outline curves. So as we can see, we have some inputs available to us. We have things like outline curve, ceiling type, and level. In addition to the ceiling creation, we do have a few other nodes to get a ceiling type by a name, get the properties of a ceiling type, and to get the name of a ceiling type. So really cool to have those features available as well. The one thing that they did add that's going to help us with this workflow is under the selection category. So let's collapse ceiling type and elements. Under selection, we now have a node for ceiling types. This is exciting because all the ceiling types available in my current project are available to me. I have an element ID right here, which represents that I have an element selected, and I can actually use this get thermal properties to see the values of that as well. So that node's really nice to be able to query a ceiling type for some of those properties. So we'll go ahead and remove this node and we'll connect the ceiling type to the ceiling type. We will also need a levels node, so I'll just scroll down on the selection category and place the levels node as well. I'm in a blank file, so I'll just pick level 1. As always, I have Monocle installed to help me with alignments. You don't have to do that. I'm just a bit OCD with how my graph lines up, so I'll link to a video on Monocle below as well. So we can see that it takes a series of outline curves. So I have my Revit model open in the background. What we could do is the easiest way to make some curves really quickly, I'll just place a rectangle. So rectangle by width and length. By default, these are italicized, so it has a default value. But I want to go ahead and make this a little more parametric. So I'll go ahead and place a slider node. So I'll search for a slider, a number slider, and we'll default it to a higher value. We'll do a control drag copy for this. That way we have a value for width and length that is parametric to where I can update it on the fly. Very cool. So now we have a rectangle getting created. If I plug this into outline curves, it will work, which is nice. So the rectangle is getting parsed into its curves for us live within Dynamo. So if I were to tile these windows a little nicer, we will see that these nodes do support element binding. So it's really cool that as I make changes in Dynamo, the Revit element updates for me. So I'm not creating like hundreds of ceiling types every time I slide a slider. That's always really nice. I'll also link to a post on element binding in the description. But element binding is both a blessing and a curse. The most important thing is just to know that it exists. One thing that I like to point out, so if we were to make something that's like a donut shape, so if we do an offset, we'll actually offset this rectangle 0, 10. That way we can get the default 1, 2. So we have two sets of poly curves. We will plug those into the ceiling by outline and type and level. We will see that the out of the box node does create two ceilings though. That is reiterated here with the green element IDs. So at this time, I don't believe this node supports donut shaped, if you will, to where this whole area would be the ceiling with a hole cut out. So that's one thing I hope to see in the future added to it. I might be using the node wrong, so I'd like to see that get added eventually. For reference, if we were to go to Rhythm, for instance, and go to Revit, Elements, Ceiling, I have a ceiling by curve loops node in here. I do take a list of curves, so you would have to explode these curves first. I don't parse poly curves or anything like that the same way that the Dynamo team does. So if we unplug this, we'll see that there is no ceiling, right? I will actually take those values though and approximate what you are wanting to create. So if you were to do a multi-sketch, you can with the Rhythm node. Another thing to point out is the Rhythm node also has element binding. So if you were to update some of these values, you'll see it update live. And you'll see the sketch mode get activated with the Rhythm node because the way that we're editing the sketch is new in the API as well. All that code's open source. Rhythm is fully open source, so you can check it out if you're someone who wants to dive into the world of the Revit API as well. Overall, I do think this is a really great node added to our toolkit. I've had people I've worked with ask about ceiling creation quite a bit for things like room creation and things like that, creating ceilings from rooms. So this is really exciting to see. And I think a lot of people will get a lot of great use out of it. In addition to the ceiling type nodes, we have a few other options in here. If we go to Revit, Elements, and we go to family instance, we will see that we have a family instance by host endpoint. This is a new node. This lets you place doors, for instance. So this is really nice because I've had to use custom packages for this as well, but you give it a host, like a wall, a family type, like a door, and a point to place it at. Great node. And let me mock this up so we can try to use it really quickly. Awesome. So now we have a wall in our project. So let's go ahead and select that wall. And we'll try to tile this window once again. One thing I want to point out is in newer versions of Dynamo, if you don't drag the exact edge of the screen, you get this weird border going on. That is for the extensions menu. So like any extension that exists comes out in that menu. And you can actually drag it, which is a little annoying when you're trying to tile your windows, but I understand why it happened. Let's go ahead and drag this down. I'll collapse my library because I don't need it. We'll just search for these nodes. And let's place a door in this wall. So we'll search for a family types dropdown. I want to find a door. So there should be a door in here somewhere. This is a sample file once again. So now I have a single flush door as my family type. I'll use a select model element for the wall. And for the point, I'm going to go ahead and do a point along the location of this wall. So the wall location should be a curve, which it is. So we'll navigate and look at that. And then we'll actually zoom out a little and we'll do a point at parameter on the wall's location. By default, we get a 0. This is italicized, so we have a default value. But if I wanted to make this a little more fun, I can actually do a slider and now slide this along the wall. So it's going to feed that point into family instance. And let's see, we might have to double check one thing. I might need to change the location line of this to that outside face. So let's go ahead and let's pick an edge actually. I think edge is going to be a little bit nicer. So we'll undo that get location. There we go. It needed the point to be at the face of the wall for that placement. So now as I slide this slider, we will see that the node takes a second to run, but as it runs, we will get an updated door placement. So really nice, placing doors is something that there are custom packages for. I specifically use a package called Wombat or a package called Spring Nodes for that, but it's kind of nice just to have it in out of the box now. So we are able to place doors and windows and anything that can be hosted on an object to where we can extract a point from that object. So really nice node, one of my other favorite nodes within this new release. Next, we'll look at some viewport stuff. So let me go ahead and open up a file that relates to that.
A few moments later.
All right, so now we have the advanced sample model open. This is important because it has a sheet that I wanted to modify. It also has a section sheet in here that we can play with as well. But what we can do is in Dynamo, so we'll fire Dynamo back up. With Dynamo open, we'll go ahead and click on New for a blank workspace. And if we navigate to Revit Elements, we should be able to scroll down until we see Viewport. So in addition to some other great nodes that have been in here for a little bit, like creating a viewport by a sheet view and location, we are able to set block centers and all sorts of crazy stuff. A lot of these are nodes from Rhythm once again, and I'm just so glad to see them in out of the box. In addition to those nodes that have been there for a little bit, we do have this label line length, label offset. And we also have set label line length and set label offset. So the nodes right here that just have one input are to query the locations, and the nodes at the top are to actually set them. So in the Revit 22 API, once again, we had a lot of new features added. One of them was to modify the view title, which hasn't really been possible in the API up until now. You can do it with some hacks, and I have a video on that from a recent blog post. It's where you just let the viewport creation do it. That's very difficult to do and not reliable. So the fact that it's now in the API is way more consistent. So I would just use the API if I were doing these interactions. So let's go ahead and pick a viewport really quickly. We'll do this with a simple select model element. We'll see that we have a viewport selected, and let's query it at first. So we will see that the line length is the length of the viewport in paper space units as it applies to that line length. The location would be this bottom left location of that viewport. So let's go ahead and tile these windows really quickly. That way we can see this update live too. So we'll keep these connected, and we'll go ahead and place this and plug it into the line length. Once again, I'll place a slider. Sliders are just pretty fun to use. Let's make it a value that makes sense and plug that into length. So now you can see that length really changing. If we go ahead and slide it on down, let's make one a zero not be an option really quickly. As we drag it down, you will see that line length change on the fly. So let's go ahead, let's make it not go too high because we're just going to break it. I want to be able to have it a little more interaction there. So now as I change that, we can start to coordinate and match our line links to what they should be in a file. So if you have a project manager who likes it to be this little short one with a scale over here on the right, you can do that and all sorts of crazy stuff. So we'll go ahead and slide this around just to see that action work out now. Another thing that is new, so if we go ahead and do a point by coordinates node, I'll plug this right into the point and we'll just see where that shows up. So you will see that 000 is that location inside of this view right now. So it's zero relative to the viewport outline. Let's get in here and go ahead and modify this a bit. So in Dynamo, if I hold down escape, I can navigate the background preview. And we can actually drag these things around. So it's going to get a little crazy here, but we will see that this should be moving. And it might take a big change, but you can start to map this out. And more often than not, you're going to use that bottom left corner of your viewport. But if you need to use something else, you can definitely do that now. So let's go ahead and drag this really high. Yeah, so if you want your viewport there, you can do that. So there it is. You can actually set that label offset. That takes a little more getting used to because it's a little bit weird how they did it, that it takes a point, but it is available to us now. So you can start to do some really neat workflows to where you can modify that. So those nodes are really great. Those are included in Dynamo 2.12 now as well. And just try them out and see what you could come up with. It's always good to test out some of these new nodes. So my hope with this video is to show you some of the new nodes available, link to resources. That way you can use them and start to embed those in your workflows. That's it for the new nodes primarily that involve Revit. There are a few other things in here. So let's go ahead and delete these nodes. A few other things that I'm really excited for as a Revit user and Dynamo user, some of these import-export workflows. In the past, for Excel, we've only had options to use Excel, so your user had to have Excel installed. I know everyone has Excel, right? But not always. That's happened a lot of times to me where we have people who rely on Google Sheets or something. They have added options in here to use an open format known as OpenXML. So instead of having to have Excel installed, you can just use these nodes to read and write Excel files. This is really great because this opens up that opportunity a bit more to use these workflows without having that restriction of Excel. It also removes that error that a lot of people have probably seen at one time or another with Excel, to where you can't write for some reason and there's some registry key broken and all sorts of crazy stuff. So those are really exciting. I might make another video using those. In addition to that, there are some of these UI changes up here. So you'll just have to play with some of those. There is a preferences menu that we'll do a video on later too. And there are some extensions included that are really nice. So I'll include another video for using some of these extensions. This one was to primarily cover Revit nodes, so there it is. There's some of the new Revit nodes, and once again, the full release notes are linked below, so check out the new nodes, have fun, and thanks for watching.